The third important aspect of approaches to design is how they are validated. As I just said, typically that means some kind of review, walkthrough, inspection by a team. It could also be the case that the tools that you're using to represent the design can do some checking for you. Some issues arise with design validation, and a key one is the independence of the validators. The problem here is that if you have the design team doing its own validation, they may be blinded to particular issues. If they didn't think about them when they were doing the design, they may not think about them when they're inspecting the design. Bringing in independent validators can help with the effectiveness of the design review. Second issue that arises is the dependence of the design validation on the design method. For structured design, there's a complete set of rules associating metrics with each of the design artifacts. On the class resource page, there's some guidelines that I've written up concerning the things that you can ask about during an object-oriented design review. A third key issue with validation is when do you do it? One strategy is to do it as you go along. That is, on a daily or weekly basis, review what you have and make adjustments. An alternative is to wait until you get to major milestones, have design reviews, and make your changes at that point.